variable and constants. A name or symbol used to represent elements of set is called a variable. For example, if X is a letter, used to represent even numbers, between 3 and 15, then X is called a variable. And the even numbers like 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 14 are called values of the variable X. While the set of values like 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Now this set is called domain of variable X, And generally, the last few letters of English alphabets like X, Y, Z are letters used to represent a variable. So note X, Y, Z. These are letters used to represent unknown quantity in the variable in a given question. L, X, Y, Z are used to represent a variable. While constant is a quantity which does not change at all, so if we want to define a constant, we can define a constant, a quantity which does not change, is called a constant. For example, the number pi, the value is equal to always 22 over 7 is a constant. So it doesn't matter whether you are doing physics, mathematics, whether you are working in Japan or America, wherever, the value of pi will be always 22 over 7. Which is in fact equal to 3.14. So this is a constant, a characteristic that is likely to change its value. That is a variable and it's represented by X, Y, Z. Now, coefficient and exponents. So what is the difference between coefficients and exponents? In order to understand the difference between coefficient and exponent, let's take an example where you are adding m plus m plus m plus m plus m. How many times did we add m? 5 times. So how we are going to write? We are going to write 5m. Here, this number that which tells us how many times the m has been added is called the coefficient of m. This is called coefficient. I-E-N-T. So what coefficient tells us, it tells us how many times an object has been added. Obviously, when you are adding the object, they must be of the same type. Only then you are going to, if m plus m plus n plus y plus z, you can't write them 5m. So the only men can be added to men. Objects must be of the same type if you are adding them up. So the coefficient tells us that how many times the like objects have been added. While if m was multiplied m times m times m times m times m. Now how many times now m has been multiplied? This is m has been multiplied 5 times, and that appears on the top right. This 5 is now called the coefficient. The exponent. Now this 5 is called exponent. Exponent. Or it is sometimes called power as well. So exponent tells us how many times the object has been multiplied with itself. The coefficient tells how many times an object has been added with itself. If you have a number, let's say 4x power 3, then 3 is called the exponent, 4 is called the coefficient, and x is a variable base. So that x is a base, but because it's a variable, you can call it a variable base. In another example, if there is example 2, if there is minus 1 over 3 x power 9, then coefficient is what? Guess what is coefficient? Coefficient, it includes the sign, algebraic sign as well. The it is equal to minus 1 over 3. So the algebraic sign, whether it's plus or minus, that makes part of the number which is before x, that is the coefficient. So what is the exponent? Exponent, that is equal to 9. And what is the base? Base is equal to x, which is of course a variable, but that's what it is. Now these terms are very important in order to start learning algebra. You must be very clear in terms of the exponents, the coefficients. Coefficient is the constant number before the variable. That is what is called the coefficient. Now, an expression. How would you define expression? Expression. Expression is the collection of variables and constants connected by algebraic operations of, so let's write it down, collection of variables and constants connected by algebraic operations of addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, and root extractions. To represent a value is called algebraic expression. And we'll give an example. For example, if we have 9x minus 15y. So here you can see that 9 is a constant, x is a variable. 9x minus 15y. This is an algebraic expression. Similarly, another example of expression is x squared plus 3x minus or plus 9. This is a combination of constants and variables which are joined by algebraic operations, and this represents an expression. Similarly, minus 2 over x cube, that is another expression provided x is not equal to 0. So these are all algebraic expressions. And now we are going to define another important piece of terminology, which is called a term. What do you mean by a term? So if we want to define a term, part of algebraic expression included between plus sign and or minus sign is called a term. So it means anything. That is, if we take a look on this algebraic expression which we have above here, so here is 9x minus 15y. So if you see this is, if there is no sign in front of 9, then obviously it is plus sign, but we don't write it. So anything that is included between this negative sign and this positive sign, that is called a term. And now from this negative sign onto the next sign, which we don't write, but there is a positive sign, this is another term. So how many terms in this? There are two terms. 9x is one term, and another term is minus 15y. So let's take a look on the example. How many terms? Has two terms. So whenever you see an algebraic expression, if you want to find out the terms, just look at the plus sign and minus sign. Anything that is included between these two algebraic signs, whether plus and plus sign, whether minus and minus sign, or plus and minus, or minus and plus sign, that is called a term. For example, there is another example here. If we write x squared plus 3x, x squared plus 3x minus or plus 9, how many terms here? Similarly, there is nothing, if there is no algebraic sign, then there is one positive sign. So positive sign to positive sign, there is one term. And from this positive sign to another positive sign, that is a second term. And from this positive sign on to the end, there is a third term. So how many terms? Has three terms. This has three terms. So therefore, if you want to find out how many terms in this example, minus 2 over x cube, this has only one term, because at the end there is positive sign and there is only one term in this. Has only one term. So this is how we determine the terms. And now we are going to see kind of algebraic expressions that we will do in the next video.